Ruslan.
You said 25%. If you can make 25% of your income, you didn't say this is an absolute rule. I would add 25% in some emergency fund in place. We had I think we had 6 months of expenses when we took that leap in 2015 with music. Nico Santana asked 25% for how long? I think that's a good question. For how long should they be able to sustain?
And I would totally agree with the emergency fund as well. Yeah. Being wise, living below your means, just to interject, once you are on the come up, still live below your means. Like, I think you should always live below it, because that's also, I think, wise stewardship for today, for the uncertainty of tomorrow.
Yep.
But 25% for how long? I think a provable time. 1 month is not enough. You're not like,
yeah,
I hit it. Like,
yeah,
that
yeah,
could have been an outlier. So I think that if you could see so this is the first time we're maybe giving you the framework. And again, this is kind of rough, but I think it could be really practical. Yeah. Emergency fund first, which also could give you a buffer for how many — you wouldn't even want to potentially eat off your emergency fund, yeah, but how many months could you go while you're building your side hustle?
Yep.
But I would argue if you've demonstrated, and for easy math, you know, how much — step one, how much money do you need to live? Not fancy, like some Jay-Z music video, you know, on, yeah, like I'm talking, how much money do you need to live? So if you need $4,000 a month to live, and it, like, eat, like, being lean, because if you really believe in your dream, you're not like, well, yeah, I also want like the sickest car payment. And no, strip down your life to minimum amount so you can work on your dream. Come on, King's dream.
Hello.
And so let's say it's $4,000. So you need $4,000 a month, and you found that from music royalties or from YouTube AdSense or from your Etsy shop,
yeah,
or from, you know, affiliate marketing or the online course you create, or even Upwork.com and you're freelancing online, or your graphic design, like, cause you have a job, but you want to just work from home and be able to, like, a lot of different ways you could do it. Or so you hit that target where you're generating now $1,000. If we really get kind of ninja, it doesn't need to be profit, but it should be $1,000 positive revenue. Like, if it costs some money to generate,
right,
that
net and profit. Yeah.
You
know, yeah.
Yeah. You walk away with $1,000. And 4K is the amount that you need. And then you can prove that out. I mean, even depends on. And then the other piece of this, yeah, 3, 4, 5, 6 months, maybe a year. But it has to do — there's two then other factors. Your risk aversion has to do with your age too, yep, and at your dependence. You got to ask yourself — I just talked to somebody yesterday on Clubhouse, not trying to be judgmental of it, but it is observational. And I mean, we were talking about my journey, and back in 2009, Ruslan, my wife almost died because she had a chronic illness, and they installed a feeding tube wrong, and it filled all this — it would have suffocated her organs because all this food was filling up her body. So she's in the hospital for 6 days. And so thank God today too, even — we didn't think we'd be able to have a family. We have our son through surgeries. God's been good, and we've been through a ton, but medical bills, surgeries — in 2010, I look back and I go, man, hindsight's 2020. If I would have went all in on Think Media back then, I was a few, you know, inches away from gold, a few feet from gold. But I believe God directs our steps. Mm. And I learned so much in the next couple of years through going to work at a church. But I also went and was a director of communication at a church because of the salary and because of healthcare. Mm-hmm. I think a huge piece here is you gotta — especially speaking to men and just speaking to myself as a leader of my family — you gotta take care of your fam, man. That's priority number one. So had I been single, bro, mate, I'm not trying to say no emergency, but you could take more risk.
Right.
Like, you could sleep on a friend's couch, you could whatever. So you could swing for the fences more. I think everybody listening to this has to reverse engineer the amount of risk. And then there's unity with your family, yes, and even your partner. Cause same thing. If my wife might've been an argument or a heated conversation about like what moves we should make. If she had been like, I want more security in this particular situation or that particular situation, even later, that's a very important conversation husbands need to be having. But on the flip side, she was for it. She's like, I believe in you. I've seen your work ethic. I've seen that you don't just say you're going to like work on your side hustle, but then I just catch you playing video games and like, you know, watching Netflix. Like, I see you really — I believe in you because you've built trust. And so let's risk together.
Yeah.
And then you have to make some of those hard decisions. But I think if you could have 6 months, you got your emergency fund, 6 months of hitting $1,000 a month, which shows your discipline because you're coming home after work to get that stuff done. When you start getting more rest, working full time on, you give your 2 weeks notice, you're working full time and your full creativity, your full mindset, your full amount of hours you clock in that allow for more magical moments to happen because you're just doing more stuff. So more connections happen and you could go to the event or get on the virtual summit or do the thing. And then a snowball hits and it seems like also kind of a small amount. It's only 25%, but it can scale quick to hit that full-time mark. And disclaimer, don't email Ruslan. But it's a real solid sound principle because it's proof of concept.
Yeah.
And then at some point, just the final thing to say, there will never be, if you go to dictionary.com and you look up the word entrepreneur, which what we are discussing is you stepping outside of a secure system of, well, But what about, what's the benefit plan? What's the healthcare plan? Right. Like, but what are the sick days? We're talking about leaving that system.
Yes.
And the definition of entrepreneur on dictionary.com is someone who takes on abnormally large risk financially.
Come on.
To pursue a business endeavor. Essentially, that's the definition. Therefore, you're never going to be able to do this. If you feel like, dude, I'm still scared though, bro. I'm still like, my palms are sweaty, knees weak, mom's spaghetti, like whatever. Like, and you know, I'm still nervous. I'm still like, you should be, dude. Yeah. It's terrifying.
Yes.
Even if like, it makes sense on, even if you're wise friends, look at you. Like you're coming. I'm like, bro, it's actually not.
Oh yeah. And they will.
Even 3 years ago, I'm like, bro, you're going to kill. Like it's already there. Yeah. With everything you've done, like the music and your skill sets, like you probably look back and think, man, had I done this, I could have probably gotten further there sooner. But dude, fear is real and the risk is real. And you got to work that out with God and you got to have that prize fighting morning routine, I think, to get into a confident state because entrepreneurship is real and there's going to be no promise. Well, Sean, are you then promising, Ruslan, are you saying that then 6 months later, 12 months later, like that, we're not saying anything. Like it's either you under a company and however secure that is, I don't even think that's secure in 2021, but that's a path, or it's you actually becoming a maverick and being on your own, becoming independent, becoming someone that is out. I don't mean maverick like Logan Paul. It immediately hit me. I literally just read maverick in the Bible, in the John Maxwell Leadership Bible. And probably nobody even noticed the Logan Paul thing, but I was like, I don't mean like a super fan of Logan Paul. I mean like, come on, Maverick, Top Gun.
Yeah.
Come on, Tom Cruise. I just mean an independent individual that steps outside of the status quo. But we are living through the greatest age of this being more realistic and more practical than ever before. You said like lightning round. That was not.
No, that was good. Just to add a bit again, we had 3 to 6 months of expenses. I knew if at 4 months I did like all of my revenue, and I was probably at about 70% of what we needed to make. So a lot of people asking, how did you get your wife on board? Sean already answered that. Like, one, communication. Two, my wife saw that I was working my face off and I was willing to do whatever it took. And three, if at 4 months we weren't generating what I had generated for the past 6 months, I was willing to go work for Uber or Instacart, you know. But one thing I knew, and this is not a judgmental statement, but one thing I knew was this is gonna sound bad. I was incompatible of working for somebody else. I reached a certain point where I was like, I just can't. Like, the opportunity cost alone of not doing your own thing to me was greater. And we had worked really hard. We had 6 months of expenses and I was willing, and I registered for Uber. I remember in February registering for Uber, and I was on staff at a church and I was on tour, and I called my wife and I said, we were in New Mexico, and I said, hey, I think we need to pray about potentially leaving my job. The writing was on the wall that pulled my, I don't know if you remember, if you ever got this, Sean, but we got clergy pay where half your income was untapped. Like, they pulled that for me.
Yeah, I got clergy pay.
Yeah, so they pulled that for me, and it was the best thing.
They negotiated that into my salary. They're like, well, we can't pay you more, but listen, you get like a tax benefit.
Yes, okay. A lot of folks get that in the church. And I remember calling her that, pulled that, I was on tour, I could tell like the writing was on the wall. And I called her and I said, hey, I think we need to pray about possibly leaving the job and putting in a 2-week notice or just trying to transition. And she told me, there's nothing we need to pray about. You need to come home and put in your 2-week notice. Mm. This is my wife with a 4-month-old. I'm sitting here being a punk. I was being a coward. My wife had more faith in me as a stay-at-home mom. I put in my 2-week notice, and like within 2 months, I had transitioned off. Best decision I could have made. Scary, but I was willing to go and drive for Uber or Lyft, and I already had that there, but thankfully, by the grace of God, I didn't have to. Sean, thank you so much. This has been incredible. Wow, this was great. Guys, here's the outro. Peace. Hey, thank you so much for making it through the end of this video. If you enjoyed it, and maybe you're feeling inspired to jump into some YouTube creator content, maybe you're an expert in the field, I have a super dope course coming very soon. No, it's not a $5,000 or $1,000 mastermind course. It's gonna be extremely affordable. So that's on the way, but we wanna give you guys a free training and PDF that's available right now. So be sure to opt into that in the description below or in the cards. Joshua the King came down and bore it all. Yeah. Conversations front of the fireplace. All of my mistakes, how do I erase? Wanna operate at a higher pace. Birth pains causing the body to dilate. On a first name basis with the worst pain facing.